First of all, guys, Happy New Year! Szczęśliwego Nowego Roku! So, guys, this video was requested by Polish subscriber. We're gonna do finally pouring out of the resin. We need two-part polyurethane resin, part A and part B. Best to have it dedicated syringes for the nice measurement. You need dedicated one so your resin doesn't stodgy up on you, and the microspheres, called sometimes micro balloon, to make it buoyant. This spoon is to dose the micro balloon, anything, some container to mix it all in, something to mix it with, stick, anything like that. Obviously, we will need our silicone mold. I will just point quickly the link to my first video on this channel, how to make a silicone mold. I'm also using this now balsa sheets on the sides of the silicone, so it makes more sturdy the lure coming, more precise, and the weighting scale, and also finally some clamps to squish your mold. Now close the mold. As you can see, I'm not putting any internal wire. This will be the simplest version of the cast resin lure with the actual screw in. The reason why I cannot have it harnessed is because this will be bent mino. So if there are harness inside, I wouldn't be able to bend it. Also, the belly hook eye, it will be on the side of the fish. So once you show that your mold is leveled, just clamp it, make it nice and sturdy, and don't squish it too much because you don't want to deform the shape of your lure later on. So we start the mixing from polyol. Let's call it part A. This is a thicker component, so that's why the microspheres are going to be mixing in nicely. You see, I wanted to already open here, but always be sure that you shake it well before you use it, because these components of this part A are separating. So once it is nicely combined, it will have like a milky consistent and uniform color. So now we can measure the part. For our lure, 5 grams of part A and 5 grams of part B is enough to fill in the mold. So now I will measure in the syringe 5 grams of this polyol, part A. Add it precisely to be exactly 5 grams, as you can see on this weighting scale. And to that I will add micro balloons, because we want to have a floating lure, walk the dog surface lure. I'm adding as much micro balloons as possible to ensure the buoyancy is really high. So in this case, I'm adding actually 11% by weight of the total liquid ingredients, 10 grams of the liquid ingredients, part A and part B, and 1.1 gram of micro balloons. You cannot really go any higher because you might have issues of the mold not being properly filled in. You might have some bubbles or even missing tail or some part of your loop. So mix in the microspheres thoroughly, then wait a little moment for the air bubbles to come out, and this is time that we'll be adding the part B, let's call it hardener. Here you need to be real fast, because once you mix it part A with part B, you have maybe 2 minutes for the mixture to still be liquidy enough so you can pour it into the mold. If you take it longer than that, then unfortunately again you will have issues with your fish, with your lure. You might get some parts missing. So you see, quick action, I'm adding again 5 grams of part B here to be sure everything is 1-to-1 ratio, mixing it quickly. Mixing, this is actually real speed, I'm not speed up this part, you really need to go fast. Once you see that the mixture is uniformed, it say after 30 seconds of mixing, you can start pouring to your mold. You can inject it, of course, if you have the tools, but just the regular gravity pouring is enough. Especially we don't have the harness inside, we don't have any weights installed, so it just fill in the form nicely. So pour it in until it reaches the top. And there we have it. The mold is full. Just wipe the excess and wait. And now I already know that my material, when it's demolded after 20 minutes, it still will be soft enough that I can play with it. I can bend it, and that's how I make my bend mino. So normally you need minimum 30 minutes if you want your lure to keep nice shape and be hard enough to start working on it. Now I'm opening it after 20 minutes very carefully. As you can see, I'm probing, touching if it is actually still slightly softish, and I decided that actually it is. So I will now carefully demold it. Really gently bend it sideways. See, you need to like apply the pressure very, very lightly, filling in. Don't make any indentations of your fingers. So as you can see, it's better if you're doing it this way, and you're just bending it sideways. How much do you need to bend it? Well, ask yourself. It comes with the experience. I'm just gonna go that much. The head just need to point a little bit out, the tail as well, and the middle of the body will be like pretty much straight. So once you see you have very nice bend, just leave it for, as I say, at least another 10 minutes. Even better if you leave it overnight, for the resin to actually completely cure and being like fully cured and dry, so then the sanding and everything else, it's okay. So this is already actually the footage from the next day. Everything turned out well, it's nicely bended. You of course kept this shape, but there are always, or sometimes, some imperfections. You need to remove the pour sprues. There are some holes, few bubble holes on top, and the tail didn't really finish completely straight. So in order to remove it, just cut all the excesses using pliers or using sharp X-Acto knife. I will just speed up the footage here. So first I'm cutting the bigger pieces with the knife, after sanding with 240 and 400 grade sandpaper. So I'll just speed up the footage and you can have a look here. So once all the sticking out imperfections are gone, you need to fill in the holes. As I mentioned, few bubble holes, indentations, the not perfectly poured tail of the lure. We will fill it in with the putty, then remove the excess putty with this X-Acto knife, sand it smooth with 400 grit sandpaper, and then we are ready to install the hardware. dual part. 0.6 millimeter stainless steel wire, again using the lightest stuff I can get away with. This lure will be used only in fresh water for more mainly aspis fishing, sometimes chub fishing, perch fishing, so we don't need really heavy gauge wire. There's not gonna be fishing in salt water with this lure. So 0.6 millimeter, cut 2.5-3 inch pieces around 7-8 centimeters, bend them into this very skinny U shape with your round nose jewelry pliers. Install it firmly in your drill. You will need some bolt. In this case, I'm just installed some broken drill bit inside my into my working bench. Then start your drill, keep it very tense, and just once you see it coiled nice and tight, you release it, and there you have it, your eyelet is ready. Repeat it 3 times and you have your hardware done. Now to install the hardware for the belly hook, I want to be sure how thick actually is my lure, and I can see it is 11 millimeters. So I will cut to the length this eyelet in order not to go to the other side and not to destroy the lure. But then again, I want to have it in this spot as deep as possible, so it is as stronger as it can be. The other two I will just cut out to slightly longer length. Again, I want them to be slightly longer, so they will give me maximum strength. And once they are cut to the side, I'll be also checking how actually thick this is. And we can see here that is 1.2 millimeters. So I will choose appropriate drill bit from my selection, so I'm sure that the holes matching the size and everything fit snugly inside. Now, using my pokey pointy tool, I'm just making little holes so so my drill won't slip, and I'm actually drilling nice centered holes. Here it will be on the, of course, the belly side. If you want to do walk the dog lure, it's best not to install the front eyelet directly in the middle of the lure, but slightly towards usually the belly. Here is towards the side that will be pointing down towards the bottom. And of course the belly hook eye, again, because you're not gonna have a lip, you won't have the issue that your hook will catch against your lip. You can go slightly towards the head with the eyelet, so then basically the hook point of your hook will be right at the center of the lure. And generally most of the bites, at least aspius, they always grab the lure from the belly right in the middle. Very rarely you will have them attaching on the back hook. So now we're using a blender tool, making the hole. Thank you. And as you can see at that point, the holes are actually so snugly fitting that you need to screw in. And this is the ideal way, because you want to have it as much tension as possible, and then of course there will be glue added to make sure everything is nice and strong. Strong enough at least for the freshwater fishing. Don't use this kind of lure in the sea, or if you go against really big fishes, because this is not strong enough. So then I'm using super glue because it works really well with this type of resin, and it hardens it inside. I never had any issue with pulling of this screw-in eyelets. As I said, of course, reasonable drag pressure, reasonable breaking strain of your main line. You don't want to go like 10 kilo of the drag pressure, because of course then it might really pull. But this is not the type of the fishing that I'll be doing with this lure. Temporarily putting the trebles with the split rings, because we will be weighting the lure. So of course you want to be sure that all the weights that will be there originally is already installed. Especially it's super important when you're making floating topwater lure like a popper or walk the dog lure, because if you, let's say, weight in it very nicely without the hooks, and then you put the hooks and the lure sinking, of course the lure is good for nothing. So here I'm just probing, taking little split shot that weighs 0.64 gram. I'm flattening it. I like to have a not ball, but in the walk the dog lure, slightly elongated a piece of the lead. So let's say you would be pouring your lead from the lead pot, just make two holes, one behind each other, with the drill, pull it like that. So now I'm gluing this piece at roughly 60% towards the tail. That's where I want to put it for the good walk the dog action. And here you can see this is not enough lead. The lure probably would work already, but since we can put it slightly more, achieve the higher casting distance, why not? So again, replace it with my next size split shot, which is in this case 0.8 gram. Again, I flatten it, I'm putting it again towards the tail, directly on the center line of the lure, and another water test. And as you can see, as for my experience, the amount of the lure that's sticking of the water right now, which is just the head, is perfect, but it's too vertical in the water. So I'm removing the weight, moving it slightly more towards the head. Now it is around, let's say, 3/4 of the lure length. And now is the beauty moment, when just the head sticking out and the lure sits at around 45 degrees in the water. And this won't change just because of the epoxy, because the epoxy, it coating the lure evenly on all the surface. So even though the lure will be slightly heavier after it, it still will sit at exactly the same angle. Now I'm just marking when I need to drill my hole. I'm removing the weight, we'll drill the hole and glue it in place. Here the tungsten carbide drill bit or Dremel bit, whichever way you want to call it, checking if it sits nice and flush, but comes out that the hole is not deep enough, the lead is still sticking. So making the hole deeper, now it fits perfectly flush with the lure body. So putting drop of the super glue, gluing it in place, and again this putty to fill any gaps, any imperfections, because if we wouldn't leave it nice and smooth, that all would show on our foil. I'm planning to foil this lure. So 400 grit sandpaper, even 600 here. And now the eyelet, the middle one, I will remove it for now. I will foil the lure first, put the scale pattern on the foil, and then only add the eyelet so I don't disturb the foil. And that's it for this week episode. I see you guys on the next Saturday in the part number 2 when we will foil and paint the lure. Subscribe to the channel and take care.